Aloha, my name is Marie Kimura, and I will be your speaker this evening. Throughout the years of the carelessness and ongoing trades, the Great Depression of the 1929 through the 1939 is considered to be one of the most unfortunate events in America that affected all classes of people nationwide. In the 1929, it was just 2 years before my Auntie Frances Harriman was born. It was the start of the Great Depression. Due to the economic situation of the United States, her family was forced to live with their grandparents so they could survive. The stock markets crashed in October 1929, causing a spiral of events to occur. This affected the workforce, causing people to become homeless, hobos, and migrant workers. The Great Depression affected people across the world in different levels. Tony Jordan of Mississippi encountered the Depression when they lost a family farm, forcing his family to become migrant workers, and move to Indiana was indisputable. Mrs. K. Kaneshiro of Kauai faced the Depression by working on the plantation farm to keep their home. They were affected by the Depression, but not as hard as those in the mainland, as Hawaii has been bartering for hundreds of years prior. Living in a middle-income neighborhood, Frances found herself, as well as everyone else, including three-year-old children, walking to every destination needing to be reached. At the time, she didn't realize the effect of the economy on her because of the time she was too young to understand the cause and effects of the situation. However, she can recall the way she was brought up. She would receive hand-me-down clothes from her older sister. All the clothes were received were all handmade, just like this dress. There was an exception to that, though. On Christmas every year, she would receive one gift as a toy, and the rest were store-bought clothes. This was a very special occasion to them. This was the way she described the Depression. Tony Jordan's reminiscences of the Depression was different from my Auntie Fran. He remembered working on his family farm. Then one day his father came home and said that they need to move. They gathered all that they could fit in their car and headed to Indiana. They moved from place to place during the Depression. It took his family 6 years before they were able to get back on their feet. By that time, Tony found himself fighting for freedom in the war. It was around 1941 when World War II began and the Depression ended. The war was a devastating impact on the people worldwide, yet it was also a turning point for civilization then, and for generations to come, as this was a time when women began to take positions of men who were out at war. They began working in factories, filling positions men would normally do. This was for the reason of having a lack of soldier support in the war. The government issued demands to recruit soldiers. By doing so, employees had no choice but to fill these positions normally held by men with women. This resulted in an array of choices for women in the workforce. The war surprisingly helped our economic situation. It helped us move away from the Depression and into a world with a stable economy. The weakness of international economy and contradicting American foreign policies unquestionably contributed to the coming of the Great Depression. The origins of the calamity must be kept in perspective, though. It must be realized that while the war collapse was cutting $1.5 billion from American exports between 1929 and through 1933, domesticated contraction was slicing $12 billion from the American gross national product. Statistically, internal problems appear to have had an effect on the American Depression, some 8 times greater than did foreign ones. This is not to underestimate the significance of the nearly 10% of the American GNP that went into exports in 1929. That $5 billion was of great importance, and the loss of a large portion of it undoubtedly affected domestic parts of the economy. But if we were to find the most telling causes of the Depression, we must look within the borders of the United States. Kindleberg, War, and Depression. Food for thought. I just want you guys to think about, you know, are we making the same mistake now as we did back then? So throughout the years of carelessness and ongoing trades, the Great Depression of the 1929 through the 1939 is considered to be one of the most unfortunate events in America that affected all classes of people nationwide.
Yeah.